Yamuna Tira Vanchari. Yayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Yayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Jaya Vishnupad, Paraman Privyaja Kacharya, Sutra Shashri Srimad Divine Grace, Nisi Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupad Ki Jaya. Nandra Srimad Bhagatam Ki Jaya, Nithai Gaur Premanande. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudire Nashta Prayeshu Bhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtiki Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha. Hare Krishna. So we are reading from Canto 11, Chapter 8, the story of Pingla, text 32. You can repeat behind me. Aho Mayatma Parita Pito Vritha. Sankitya Vrityati Vigarya Vartaya. Svenana Radhyartha Trishonu Sochayat. Kiritanen Vittam Ratim Atmanichyati. Aho Mayatma Parita Pito Vritha. Sankitya Vrityati Vigarya Vartaya. Srenanna Radhyartha Tishonu Sochayat. Kritena Vittam Ratim Atmanichyati. Aho Mayatma Parita Bhuto Vritha Ketya Vrityati Vigarya Vartaya Enyana Yartha Tishonu Sochaya. Parita Pito Vritha
Aketya Vrityati Varyavartaya Aho mayatma paritapito vrita sanketya vrityati vigarya vartaya strayanandra vyakshiti sonu sochaya
Matajis?
Aho mayatma paritapito vrita sanketya vrityati vigarya vartaya kritena vittam ratim atma nechati Aho mayatma paritapito vrita sanketya vrityadi vayavate Srinanda radyata dushana sochayat kritena vittam ratim atma nechati
Aho Aho Maya, by me, Atma, the soul, paritapitaha, subjected to great pain, vritha, uselessly, sanketya, of a prostitute, vittaya, by the occupation, ativigharaya, most reprehensible, vartaya, occupation, Strenat, from lusty woman hunters. Tarat, from men. Ya, who? Arthatrisha, from the greedy. Anusochayat, the pitiable. Kritain, that which, with that which was sold. Mittam, money. Pratim, sex pleasure, Atmana, with my body, Ichchati, desiring. Translation and purport by the disciple of His Divine Grace, Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Oh, how I have uselessly tortured my own soul. I have sold my body to lusty, greedy men who are themselves object of pity. Thus, practicing the most abominable profession of a prostitute, I hoped to get money and sex pleasure. Purport: the art of prostitution is based on awakening the enjoying propensity in men. Apparently, this prostitute was so foolish that she maintained a romantic conception of her profession and was actually trying to enjoy loving affairs with her customers, not realizing that they were the lowest of men with the most abominable motives. Like the prostitute Pingla, one should understand that by giving up the devotional service of the Lord, one simply becomes the victim of the illusory energy and suffers greatly.
Om Jnana Dhimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasme Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Tapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kada Mahiyam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamala Shri Gurum Vaishnavam Cha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakham Vitamsha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishvanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindubhevacha Paritanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Itinamini Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pacharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyati Vishatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gauravhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare
Hare Krishna. So I seek the blessing of all assembled Vaishnavas. So in this section, there was a prostitute in long time, is a story long time back, it's not of recent time. So there was a prostitute, Pingla, and she was desiring wealth and enjoyment. And one day she was very much frustrated. So she had a great detachment, right, out of frustration. Usually out of frustration one doesn't get attachment, that's not the general rule. A person may be frustrated but he continues to try hard. Right? And there are many motivational speakers, motivational books that don't be frustrated. You have to try in this way or that way, with this attitude or that attitude and so on. Right? But Pingla, she was fortunate that out of her frustration, detachment came to her. Right? She had, it's mentioned that she had unknowingly served some devotees. There was some Sukriti with her. Due to some service which she had rendered unknowingly, when she was frustrated, in that frustration, great realization came. But usually not the case. So, she's speaking her realization in this section. The number of verses she's speaking. In this particular verse, she's saying, Aho mayatma paritapito vritha. Oh, I have uselessly tortured my own soul. Aho mayatma, my own soul, paritapito. Paritapito means to torment. Vritha, uselessly. I have been uselessly tormenting my own soul. And in the purport, the disciple of Prabhupada is saying, like the prostitute Pingla, one should understand that by giving up the devotional service of the Lord, one simply becomes the victim of the illusory energy and suffers greatly. So, we should understand that the material atmosphere is actually a great torment for the spirit soul. It doesn't really matter how good or bad the conditions are. The material world or the material atmosphere itself is a torment for the spirit soul. Kurma Brahman, he says, this is a little more than 500 years back, Kripa kara prabhu more yana toma sange sahi tena pari dukha vishayata range. The Kurma Brahman begged Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, my dear Lord, kindly show me favor and let me go with you. I can no longer tolerate the waves of misery caused by materialistic life. Sahi tena pari dukha vishayata range. And Prabhupada says, this statement is applicable for everyone, right? Now regardless of the material situation. This statement is applicable for everyone, regardless of how rich or prosperous one may be. Rotam Das Thakur has confirmed this statement. Samsara Vishanale Diva Nishi Hiya Jole Juraite Na Koi Nu Upai. He states that the materialistic way of life causes the burning in the heart, right? Paritapito, as we read in this verse. So materialistic way of life causes the burning in the heart. One cannot make any provisions for the troublesome life of the material world. It is a fact that one may be very happy as far as riches are concerned, and one may be very opulent in every respect. Yet one has to manage the vishayas to meet the demands of the body. So many material things and so on, that is vishayas. To meet the demands of the body and of so many family members and subordinates, one has to take so much trouble to minister to others. Thus, one must become free from the materialistic way of life. One has to merge himself in the ocean of transcendental bliss. In other words, one cannot relish transcendental bliss without being freed from the materialistic way of life. It appears that the Brahmana named Kurma was materially very happy. Right? So this Kurma Brahman was, because he himself says in one of the verses previous to that, Mur bhagye rasima naya ekahan, aji murash lagya haila janma kula dhan. So Prabhupada says he is saying, he is talking about janma kul dhan, that means he had a high birth, he had a high lineage, and he had a good amount of wealth. Right? So he was quite wealthy, materialistic, he was well situated, but still he is saying, I cannot tolerate the pangs of material existence. Gopinath Chandrabhu was sharing, recently he went to Bangalore. He met many persons who were materially very well situated. Really had a huge amount of estate. One of them was even the founder of one of the great successful enterprise. Right? But when they met him, they revealed, Sahitena Pari Dukh Vishaya Tarangi. Right? We are unable to tolerate the pangs of material existence. Right? He was sharing that they want what to do, tell us. Right? Whatever we wanted to do, accomplish, enterprising and so on, we have done that. We don't see the way out. Right? We are not happy really. Rather we are suffering, we are being tormented. Sahitena pari dukha vishaya. Oho mayatma paritapito vritha, as the prosecutor is also saying. So the Kurma Brahman, although very well situated, he says, unable to tolerate the pangs of material existence. Therefore, material world, no matter where a person is situated, right, whatever is the situation externally, but this is material world itself is a place of torment for the spirit soul. Sometimes people may say that devotees have pessimistic attitude toward the material world. Right? The world is not so bad. There are many beautiful things to see. There are many scenes to explore. There are many high resolution photos to be taken with iPhone 10, right? And so on. Right? There are so. Actually, Kapil Dev in third canto, he says, endowed with right vision, one should have a pessimistic attitude toward material life. Actually, that pessimism toward material life produces optimism towards spiritual life. Right? So, in one of the verses written that. So this pessimistic attitude, even if we accept, okay, we are pessimistic, but that's quite realistic. And it produces optimism toward the spiritual life. So, people in general feel that world is not so bad after all. Right? So that's the nature of the illusory energy, that one accepts struggle for existence as a happiness. Prabhupada was, I was hearing one lecture and Prabhupada was saying, A person is traveling and he spends 2 hours, 3 hours. There is a lot of traffic jams on the road in the city life. If a person is traveling by vehicle, or even the local trains are so crowded, right? So Prabhupada says, but he feels he is happy because he has a nice car. He can't see that, but his car is stuck in the traffic jam. No, but he's still in a nice car. Right? He's better situated than the one in Kalipili car. Right? So he's in the same traffic jam. Right? The suffering is there, 2 hours, 3 hours traveling, right? Being stuck. But somehow he feels he is better situated. Right? He has a nice luxury car. So Prabhupada gives this example in one of his talks. Maitreya Rishi, he describes various species. One peculiar characteristic of human species which Maitreya Rishi describes is Rajo Adhika Karma Para Dukhe Cha Sukhama Nina. Rajo Adhika Karma Para. Humans are always passionately busy. Rajo Adhika Karma Para. Always passionately very busy in the midst of miserable life. But they think themselves happy in all respects. Rajo Adhika Karma Para Dukhe Cha Sukhama Nina. Right? So they are passionately very busy in the midst of miserable life, but they think themselves happy in all respects. Right? That's the peculiar characteristic of human species. So the Prabhupada writes again in one of the purports of 8th canto. He says, this material world is characterized by struggle for existence and survival of the fittest is a well-known principle. But the poor souls of this material world do not know what is survival and who is fit. So Prabhupada says, survival, he further explains, survival doesn't mean that one should not die. Right? Sometimes survival in general that one is not dying, one is still living. So survival doesn't just mean that one should not die. Rather, survival means that one should enjoy. One should enjoy everlasting happiness. Right? So survival means one is happy, one is connected with Krishna. So that is the meaning of survival. And devotees are only survive, you know, they are surviving, or they are the only person who are fit. Right? Others, Bhagavatam says, they are simply like living like a corpse, right? Living corpse. Again, Lord Brahma, in one of his prayers to Lord Vishnu on the shore of the milk ocean, he says, Klesh bhurani alpasarani karmani vifilani va. Materialistic people are always anxious to accumulate wealth for their sense gratification, but for that purpose they must work very hard. Klesh bhuri alpasarani. So they work very hard. Yet even though they work very hard, the results are not satisfying. And most often, karmani vifalani va. It's end only in frustration. So there is a hard work, but the results are very meager. And often it ends in frustration. Again, Vidurji says the same thing, the third canto. Soham nirnam shulla sukhaya dukkham mahadgatanam viramayatasya pravartaye bhagavatam puranam yadaha sakshat bhagavan rishibhya. Soham ninam shulla sukhaya. Actually Maitreya Rishi is saying, Vidurji asks a question that people are working very hard but they obtain very meager results. What can they do to rectify the situation? So Maitreya Rishi is saying, let me now begin speaking on the Bhagavat Puran which was directly spoken to the great sages by the personality of Godhead for the benefit of those who are entangled in extreme miseries
for the sake of very little pleasure. Let me now begin speaking on the Bhagavatam, mainly saying this Bhagavatam is for the benefit of those who are entangled in extreme miseries for the sake of very little pleasure. That's what Pingala is also talking. Ho mayatma paritapito vritha. Uselessly, I have tormented my soul. I have been looking for all these pleasures, but there have been only miseries. So, this Bhagavatam is spoken for the benefit, for our benefit, for benefit of all the human beings. So, the nature of material existence and its pleasure has been very beautifully analyzed by Prahlad Maharaj. Next Sunday we'll be celebrating Narsimha Chaturdashi, so I thought I can discuss some of the teachings of Prahlad Maharaj. 5-year-old child, the way he analyzes and portrays the material existence is actually quite amazing. Right? Or he has done in the best possible way. Right? There are many places where the nature of the material existence is illusory nature and so on discussed, but Prahlad Maharaj has given the most perfect picturization or most perfect understanding. So Prahlad Maharaj is teaching all his classmates, all 5-year-old children, right? Prahlad Maharaj is speaking all the verses which we are going to discuss to 5-year-old children. Sukham endriyakam detya deha yogena dehinam sarvatra labhyate daivad yatha dukham mayatnatah. My dear friends born of demonic families, the happiness perceived with reference to the sense objects by contact with the body can be obtained in any form of life. Deham sukham indriyakam detya deha yogena dehinam sarvatra labhyate daivad. It can be obtained in any form of life according to one's past activities. Such happiness is automatically obtained without endeavor, just as we obtain distress. Narada Muni has also made the similar point. Where he says the intelligent person should not strive for anything which is available in the foreign planetary system. So, actually this point has been repeatedly discussed, but it's very difficult to really take it down the throat. That don't strive for material happiness. Right? Obviously, how can we be happy without striving for it? Right? You have to work. Just like you obtain misery without working hard for it. Right? That's the simple, every time there's a simple logic or the answer given. Just like a person obtains misery, you will obtain happiness also without working hard for it. Right? But a person may think, but I am not happy because I'm not working hard for material happiness. My misery is due to because I am not working sufficiently hard. But again Bhagavatam says that hard work itself is a misery. Kalesh bhuri alpasarani. That hard work itself is so much misery. And the fruits are very meager. Karmani vifalani cha. So again Prabhupada writes in the purport, there is no need to waste time and energy fighting against distress or working very hard for happiness. Our only business in the human form of life should be to revive our relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead and thus become qualified to return home back to Godhead. Material happiness and distress come as soon as we accept a material body, regardless of what form. We cannot avoid such happiness and distress under any circumstances. The best use of human life, therefore, lies in reviving our relationship with the Supreme Lord Vishnu. But then, fine, the results may not be in proportion, but still what is the hard in trying? Right? One can work hard, just try it out. Try out your luck. Right? Prahlad Maharaj says, tat prayaso na kartavyo yat ahur vaya param. Tat prayaso na kartavyo yat ayur vaya param. he says, from say, what is the harm? Prahlad Maharaj says, valuable time will be wasted. Please realize that. Don't simply waste your time. Yat ayur vayaya param nathatha vindate shemam mukunda charanam bhujam. Endeavors mainly for sense gratification or material happiness through economic development are not to be performed. Tat prayaso na kartavyo. For they result only in loss of time and energy with no actual profit. If one's endeavors are directed towards Krishna consciousness, one can surely attain the spiritual platform of self-realization. There is no such benefit from engaging oneself in economic development. Thus, again, Bhagavatam reminds us that the time is very valuable, especially the time in the human form is very limited. From one perspective, human form of life will pass away like a flash of lightning. From the perspective of so many millions of lifetimes which we are going through, human form of life is just like a flash of lightning. Right? It passes away very quickly. Right? So therefore, Prahlad Maharaj is saying, don't think, oh, just 5 years old, you know, at least let us study well, have good career. What are you saying? You know, at the age of 5, looks like most impractical advice. Right? Just imagine, can you tell any 5-year-old child like this? People will consider you crazy. Right? Most impractical and a crazy person. 5-year-old child, of course, he has to play, study, right? And so on. But anyway, Prahlad Maharaj is quite convinced. Right? And he's saying, don't act in a way that the time will be wasted. You also don't have much time. Right? Just like there is a story how one old lady was telling her son, they were filling water in the Yamuna, right, in Vrindavan. So this old lady is telling her son, hurry up, time is running out. The sun is setting, we have to go. So, he was saying, fill up the water fast, it's getting dark, the sun is setting, you have to hurry up, you don't have much time, right? You have to go a long way. This was heard by Lala Babu, right? One of the merchants from Bengal or Orissa, that area he was visiting. And this resounded in his mind, time is running out, the sun is setting. You have to go a long way. Hurry up. Right? This was resounding in his mind. He decided not to go back, right? To attend to all his business and so on. Stayed back in Vrindavan. There is a temple to his name also, Lala Babu's temple. Well, there's a story, it's a long story, it's quite. But the time is actually imperceptibly moving very fast. Kaleen gabhiram hasa. Without our really, we are unable to understand how the time is going away very fast, imperceptibly, and suddenly we are faced with a notice. Okay, now we have to quit, right? And a person is shocked like that. So there is not much time in the human form of life. Bhagavatam reminds us that again and again. Prahlad Maharaj is reminding us. So, Prahlad Maharaj is giving a very beautiful advice. Tat prayaso na kartavyo yat ayur vaya param. Chanakya Pandit also says, Ahisha shana ekopi na labhate swarna koti bhi. Even one moment of time which has passed away, one moment of lifetime that passed away, one cannot get it back. Not even one moment in return for all the wealth one may have. Swarna koti bhi. Not paper notes koti bhi. Right? Actual gold coins. Millions of them. You can't get one moment back. So Prabhupada writes in this context, especially in the present age, every man is in darkness in the bodily conception of life, not knowing anything of the spirit soul and its needs. People are simply wasting time and the valuable gift of the human form. Thus one loses the true benefit of human life, which is to become Krishna conscious and solve life's real problems. Prahlad Maharaj continues, Tato yatet kushala shemaya bhavam ashritaha shariram paurusham yavan navipaddeta pushkalam. Therefore, while in material existence, bhavam ashritaha, a person fully competent to distinguish wrong from the right must endeavor to achieve the highest goal of life as long as body is stout and strong and not embarrassed by dwindling. Again, Prahlad Maharaj is saying, now the body is still strong and stout, is not embarrassed by dwindling. Tato yatet kushala. Now is the time to endeavor hard, to work hard, right, to perfect one Krishna consciousness. So, King Kulshekhar has written a prayer which Prabhupada used to recite often. Krishna todiya pad pankaj panjarantham advaiva me vishtu manas rajahamsa prana prayana samaye kafavat pitte kantha varodhan vidho smaranam kutaste. Right? So Prabhupada would recite this prayer often. Krishna todiya pad pankaj. Now while I am still young and my senses are strong, let the swan of a mind take shelter of a lotus feet. Right? Because when the old age comes, prana prayana samaye, there will be great imbalance in kaphavata and pitta. Right? The chest will be producing various musical notes. Right? kaphavata pitta, kantha varodhana vidho. How will I be able to chant? Right? The cough will be choking up my throat. So it will become very difficult at that point of time. In another verse, King Kulshekhar says, Idam shariram parinamu peshalam patatte vashyam shat sandhi jar jaram kim aushadam prichyasi mooda durmate niramayam krishna rasayanam piba. Idam shariram parinam upeshalam. You all know this body is transforming very fast. Parinam upeshalam, the body's beauty is fleeting. And at last, patatte vashyam, the body must succumb and fall down. But before that, hundreds of his joint would become stiff. Right? Shatasandhi jarajaram. There are many finer joints. Some people say, I have a joint pain. That means this main joint in the knees, but there are hundreds of other joints, right? Shatasandhi, there are many joints, they all will become gradually stiff, right? Jarjaram, and there will be pain in various joints of the body. But the medical science is very advanced, right? There are many tonics, elixirs, health supplements, and so on. Kim aushadam prichyasi moodh durmate, you fool, rascal, what medicine you are looking for? Right? King Kulshekhar, like quite heavily, Kim aushadham prichyasi mood durmate niramayam krishna rasayanam piba. Just take the Krishna elixir, the one cure that never fails. That's how Prabhupada translates. Just take the Krishna elixir, the one cure that never fails. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Prahlad Maharaj continues to children, his classmates. Koti prayasho surabalaka hare upasane swe ridhi chidravat sata susyatmana sakhyurashesha dehinam samanyata kim vishayopapadhine. को अति प्रयासो असुर बाल का हरेर. ओ माय फ्रेंड्स सन ऑफ द असुरास, द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी गॉडहेड इन ए सुपर सोल फीचर ऑलवेज एग्जिस्ट विद इन द कोर्स ऑफ द हार्ट ऑफ ऑल लिविंग एंटिटीज. Indeed, he is a well-wisher and friend of all living entities, and therefore there is no difficulty in worshipping the Lord. Ko ati prayaso. Is there any great endeavor in worshipping the Lord? Rama says, no. He is there, he is very close, is in the heart. There is no difficulty at all in worshipping him. Why then people not engage in his devotional service? Prahlad Maharaj is wondering, he is asking. Or is urging, why then people should not engage in devotional service? Why are they so addicted to unnecessarily producing artificial paraphernalia for sense gratification? Kati prayaso asur balaka hare. Even Pingala, she gives a similar realization by saying, santam samipe ramanam pratipradam, that the Lord is closest to us, right? And he can give us the highest pleasure. Then where have I been looking the pleasure outside of him? Santam samipe ramanam ratipradam. So Prahlad Maharaj is telling the cowherd, his classmates. Cowherd boys are there, right? Krishna. So Prahlad Maharaj is telling his classmates, there is not much endeavor, kothi prayaso, not much endeavor in worshipping the Supreme Lord. And Prabhupada again gives a brilliant purport. He says, therefore, there is no difficulty in coming in contact with the Supreme Lord because he is closest. On the other hand, going to hell requires great endeavor. Right? To worship the Lord doesn't require great enterprising and so on. But going to hell requires a great endeavor. If one wants to go to hell by illicit sex, meat eating, gambling and intoxication, he must acquire so many things. He must arrange for money, for brothels. For meat eating, he must arrange many slaughterhouses. For gambling, he must arrange for casinos and hotels. And for intoxication, he must open many breweries. Clearly, therefore, if one wants to go to hell, he must endeavor very much. But if one wants to go back home, back to Godhead, there is no such difficult endeavor. To go back to Godhead, one may live alone anywhere in any condition and simply sit down, meditate on the Super Soul and chant and hear about Lord. Thus, there is no difficulty in approaching the Lord. Right? So, Prahlad Maharaj encourages that in approaching the Lord, there is not much difficulty. Right? So in that prayer of the Lord Brahma, which we just discussed, Lord Brahma has further said, Klesh Bhuri Alpasarani Karmani Vifalani Va. We already discussed Klesh Bhuri Alpasarani. The struggle is very hard, the endeavor is very much, but the result is very meager. Dehi Naam Vishayartha Naam Ne Tathayavar Pitam Tui. But this is not the same when one endeavors for devotional service. When one endeavors for Krishna consciousness, Prabhupada says results are out of proportion to one's expectation. Right? Not meager. Prabhupada writes, we can practically see how devotees who have dedicated their lives for the service of the Lord in the Krishna consciousness movement are getting immense opportunity for the service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead without working very hard. The Krishna consciousness movement actually started with only 40 rupees, but now it has more than 40 crore worth of property. This is in early 1970. Right? And all this opulence has been achieved within 8 or 10 years. No karmi can expect to improve his business so swiftly. Right? For rights, from 40 rupees to 40 crore rupees within 8 or 10 years. Prabhupada would often say that to many Marwadi businessmen in India. Prabhupada quote these statistics so that they may take up to Krishna consciousness movement. Right? So, whatever a materialistic person acquires is temporary and sometimes frustrating. In Krishna consciousness, however, everything is encouraging and improving. Right? So again, Prabhupada gives brilliant understanding how in materialistic endeavor, everything is temporary and frustrating. But in Krishna consciousness, everything is encouraging and improving. So in this way, Prahlad Maharaj teachings are so valuable, so precise, so inspiring. Similarly, we will discuss the teachings of another Mahajan, the elephant Mahajan, right? Gajendra. Of course, his name is not counted officially, but because he worshipped the Lord and satisfied him with his prayers, he is also one of the Mahajans. So, Gajendra, his realization is also very great. So, Gajendra actually, we all know Gajendra was in a great difficulty. Right? He was caught up by the crocodile. He was suffering. He tried very hard on his own, but could not be relieved. Ultimately, he offered prayers to the Supreme Lord. So, while he's offering prayers to the Supreme Lord, Gajendra, in one of the prayers, says, I actually do not want to be delivered from this crocodile. In one of the prayers, he says that, right? It may go unnoticed sometimes. Jiji vishena hamiha muyakim. I don't wish to live any longer in this world or even in any other bodily form. Jiji vishe na hamiha muyakim. Antar bahischavrida ebhyonaya. Ichchami kale nanayasya viplavas. Tasyatma loka varnasya moksham. So, Gajendra, as he is offering prayers to the Supreme Lord, his Krishna consciousness is enhanced. He began offering prayers so that he may be relieved from this temporary suffering. But then his Krishna consciousness awakens and he realizes that living in the bodily concept of life was also like being in the jaws of a crocodile of material existence. That was even a situation worse than this one. Therefore, he says, my Lord, don't just deliver this body. I don't want deliverance of this body. I want you to deliver me from the bodily concept of life, which I've been living in. That was actually a more dangerous situation, which I didn't realize, which I realize now. Therefore, I don't want to just live any longer right, in this body or in any other higher body. Right. I want you to destroy my ignorance, right, my bodily concept of life. Ichhami kale nanyasya viplavas. Again, this is a beautiful word which says how everything in this world is destroyed in due course of time, but not the ignorance. Right, not the ignorance. So therefore, please destroy my ignorance, which has been covering me from inside outside. So, further, Gajendra offers a very beautiful prayer. Ekantino yasya na kanchanartham vanchanti yevai bhagavat prapanna tyadbhutam tacharitam sumangalam gayant ananda samudra magna. So, Gajendra says, Ekantino yasya na kanchanartham vanchanti yeva bhagavat prapanna. Those who are unalloyed devotees, ekantino, they do not desire anything, yasya na kanchanartham, do not desire anything from the Supreme Lord except His service. Vanchanti yeva bhagavat prapanna. They only want to serve and surrender to the Lord. Do not want anything else. Atyadbhutam chacharitam sumangalam. they always merge in the ocean of transcendental bliss, right? Of charitam sumangalam, of singing and glorifying your all auspicious activities. Ati adbhutam tat charitam sumangalam gayante ananda samudra magna, right? So Vijendra is saying that agar dubke marna hai to lake mein dubke kyun maru, right? Dubke marna hai to samudra mein dubke marna chahiye, right? Gayanti ananda samudra magna, let me drown in the ocean, not this small lake. So, ocean of the bliss of glorifying Krishna, Gayanti Ananda Samudra Magna, the ocean of transcendental happiness obtained by hearing, chanting and glorifying the Supreme Lord. I want to drown in that ocean. Right? Now, if you save me from this lake, but ultimately I want to drown anyway. So, in this way, Gajendra offered his prayers. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling to South India and delivering many people, especially the various scholars, the Buddhists, Jains, Mayavads and so on, is compared to his delivering the elephant Gajendra from the crocodile of various deviant theories. There is a verse that Nana Mat Graha Grastan Dakshinatya Janadvipan, right? Kriparina Vimuchetan Gauras Chakreja Vaishnavan. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nana Mat Graha Grastan. Nana Mat means various philosophies. Graha Grastan, Graha means crocodile. So in the South India, most of the people, they were being devoured by the crocodiles of various deviant theories. Right? Dakshinatte Janadvipan, and they are compared to very strong elephant. That means they were really thorough in those deviant philosophies. Kripa Arina Vimuchetan. So the Lord, with his disc of his mercy, he cut them or released them from those deviant philosophies. So it's mentioned here, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu converted the inhabitants of South India. Those people were as strong as elephants, but they were in the clutches of crocodiles of various philosophies, such as Buddhist, Jain and Mayavad philosophies. With his disc of mercy, the Lord delivered them all by converting them into Vaishnavas, devotees of the Lord. So, Srila Prabhupada would often say, right, that as we discussed, that how survival doesn't mean not just to die, right, but to enjoy, right, enjoy everlasting happiness. So to the degree we have the desire to serve Krishna, to the degree we have enthusiasm, to that degree we have life. Right? Otherwise the body is simply a living corpse. So Prabhupada, even in the fag end of his life, he was giving Bhaktivedanta purports, right? He was living till end, till the last breath. He was speaking about Krishna. And whenever any book would come, he would hold that book to his heart. He would say, this is life. What is this body? The bag of bones, flesh, that's not life. This is life. Right? He would hold his book, being very proud of a new publication, that this book, this glorification of Krishna, that is life. Right? Otherwise, this bag of bones and flesh and so on, that is not life. Therefore, the life means to glorify Krishna. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu offers one prayer. Yatevam shidho ni sukha na dekhi se chand mukha yadyapi nahi ka alambana nij dehe kari priti keval ka mera riti pran ki tera kariye dharana. So Lord is saying, even though I do not see the moon-like face of Krishna as he plays on his flute, and although there is no possibility of meeting him, still I take care of my own body. This is the way of lust. In this way, I maintain my insect life. In this way, I maintain my insect-like existence. Right? So, life is to glorify Krishna, right? That is the meaning of life. Or to hear and chant about Krishna, that is the life and soul of the devotees. There is another beautiful story of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. How, when he had, toward the end of his sojourn in this world, when the body was growing old, he was having some heart palpitations kind of, and one day the doctor came and the doctor said, you are speaking too much, right? He would often speak 10 to 12 hours, right? He would talk formally, informally, talk to the guests and so on, right? 10 to 12 hours he would often speak. Even when he would be sick, sometimes he would speak at least 6 to 8 hours. So doctor said, you are speaking too much. It is putting pressure on your heart. You have to cut down all the speaking. He said, the only purpose of life is to glorify Krishna. If you cannot hear and chant about Krishna, what use is to maintain this existence? For what purpose should we maintain the body? And he spoke for 1 hour to this doctor. And the doctor was fully convinced that the life means to glorify Krishna. Right? Krishna consciousness is the life. Otherwise, there is no life. The bag of bones and the flesh is not life. He was fully convinced. Right? And the disciple of Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur said, the doctor came to treat, but his bhava rog, the disease of material existence, has been treated today, right? Forever, by our spiritual master. Okay, I would like to briefly discuss about one more topic, but if there is any question we can take at this point regarding whatever we have covered till now. Mahaprabhu, Prabhu. First, you can correct me if I said something which is inappropriate. Please feel free to.
You have wonderfully mentioned about Prahlad Maharaj's prayers of Gajendra, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And one thing is troubling me, that when you said very important part about Prahlad Maharaj, that one should not work hard, everything is already predestined. Now, this is like a Supreme Court judgment. And Srila Prabhupada tried 33 years here in India. Nobody was interested to even listen to Srila Prabhupada. And total society, total education system family life, everywhere, people are talking, work hard. You mean to say that total everything is all useless and only highly educated people like you or IITians, they are only fit people to understand this subject, otherwise everybody is a fool who is working like a donkey. Because to reach to understand this subject, one has to get highly educated. So everything what is going on in the society, which is brainwashing us completely, and total education system is completely useless, as Srila Prabhupada also said several times. So what is the hope of today's people? Because merely coming few people, 101% people in temple, majority of the people, even they come here, they listen, they don't apply even life also. So how, what is the solution? Whether they have to just, after finishing education, they join, like you people and like Gaurang Prabhu and Gaurari Prabhu, they just forget everything else and they have to come in temple and sit down here and talk about Krishna.
Hare Krishna. You can yourself answer also, or and you also. Well, I'll just like to say a few things. First of all, it's not that to understand this philosophy one needs to be very highly educated materially. Spiritual education is needed. One need to be educated, but as Prahlad Maharaj says from the very beginning, the spiritual education should be given. And then this point can go deep into a person's life. And we saw that actually these students were convinced and their habits changed, and that caused fear in the parents. Right? That's all mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Right? So therefore the spiritual education needs to be introduced in society from the very beginning, as exemplified by Prahlad Maharaj. And also it's not that one has to totally renounce everything and become a full-time person. Right? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he doesn't approve of Kurma Brahmana leaving everything. Right? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him that you stay over here in your position, you chant the holy name of the Lord, and the waves of material existence will not trouble you. Right? So, Lord Brahmaji also says, Stane chita shuddhi katam dhanuvan manobhir. So one has to stay in one's particular situation. And one gradually makes progress. So gradual progress, step by step progress is actually encouraged by Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also tells Raghunath Das Goswami that sthirahaiya ghare jao na ho vatul krame krame paaye lok bhav sindhu kul. So krame krame, right? One, you become steady, don't become suddenly so crazy as to give up everything suddenly. By and by, step by step, one will be able to cross the ocean of nescience and reach the shore. So therefore, step by step approach is recommended by the Lord. Right? So gradually one will be able to. So this step is actually a very nice acronym to understand gradual progress which we all can make, right? And we can't suddenly give up our duties which we have. So Krishna is recommending a stepwise approach. So step, S-T-E-P. So the step S stands for, Krishna says, you stay on the battlefield first of all, right? Don't run away, right? Don't be so eager to just run away from the battlefield. Stay on the battlefield, S stands for that. T, Krishna says, a true sannyasi. You become a sannyasi on the battlefield. Be renounced, don't be attached to the results. Fight for the sake of duty, do your duty. Right? So therefore, get the spirit of renunciation first. That's a true sannyasi, one who is renounced in spirit. So Krishna says, become a true sannyasi while you're still on the battlefield. And E stands for that one cultivate eagerness while one is in stay in particular position, while one try to imbibe the spirit of detachment, right? The spirit of detachment. One should simultaneously try to cultivate the eagerness, and in this way gradually one will progress, right? P stands for progress gradually, right? So staying in a particular position, cultivating a spirit of detachment while simultaneously cultivating eagerness to hear about Krishna, one will proceed step by step. So Krishna recommends this gradual approach himself. Antare nishtha bahya kar loka vahavar achirat Krishna to mai karibe uddhar. Antare nishtha, again Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives the same advice. Inside you cultivate firm devotion toward the Lord. Bahya loka vahavar, externally in this world you have to behave as it is required, but in a spirit of detachment, right? Gradually, so one has to cultivate detachment and attachment simultaneously, and in this way progress gradually, step by step, the Lord says. So I'm not sure whether I've really answered your point, but I'm sure you know very well. You just engaged me in speaking something. Hare Krishna. Any other question or any point someone wants to? Oh, okay, please. Okay, Radha Gopinath Prabhu can make a comment. Later you can.
When Mahaprabhu was asking this question, I was reminded of one question asked by Krishna Chandra Prabhu to Holiness Radhana Swami Maharaj way back, I think in 93-94, where Maharaj was speaking about you should become a best devotee and you should also become a best in whatever you're doing. So Krishna Prabhu asked this question, said, Maharaj, you want us to become a best devotee, you want us to become a best businessman, you want us to become a best student, but let me tell you, to become a best businessman, they spend at least, 18 hours, and then they really have to struggle and they have to do this. And to become a best devotee, you want us to come every Sunday. You want us to chant 16 rounds every day. You want us to go to all the programs. You want us to preach. But there are only 24 hours. So, how do we become best in both? And I was thinking, I was just, you know, quite new at that time. And I was telling him, sahi mein yaar, kya bolenge abhi? Pakda, aise jagah pakda abhi dekhenge kya? And as always, he came out with such a brilliant answer as ever. He said, I want you to become best, but in whose eyes? He said, I want you to become a best devotee and a best businessman in the eyes of Krishna, not in the eyes of the world. Then he said, Karna and Arjun, both were best, but in the eyes of Krishna, Arjun was the best fighter, best archer, because he used his archery in Krishna's service. And you know, that's how he kind of resolved. And this was also my question, you know, as you were speaking, so much on renunciation, you know, suddenly, because Gita tells you how to live and Bhagavatam tells you how to live. So how do we manage? So one devotee just thought, one devotee expressed very nicely. He said, you know, as life is a preparation, death is the examination, we say. So the examination is, as Krishna says, sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam charanam braja. So yes, 6 days you can work and hard like anything in your profession. And the 7th day is weekly test. Sarva dharman parityajya. Come here. Run to the association of devotees. Recharge your battery. So that rest of the week, while externally struggling, internally the eagerness is growing. So it's not artificial, but while you're in the world, fully absorbed, the heart is internally being cultivated towards when will Sunday come? Or when will the day come when I, you know, that weekly off as we look for Sunday. person look for a vacation or holiday. So that shelter in the association of devotees, I get to hear Krishna Katha. If that eagerness is there, then when the outside job finishes, you run here, and eventually when you retire, then naturally the inclination is cultivated within. So spontaneously and naturally come and do what you always wanted to but didn't have much time because of other responsibilities. So there's some
thought. Yeah, thank you.
Actually, from my angle, I was watching you and you were looking that side, so I was feeling suddenly that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is sitting on the Vyasasana.
I'm actually not fit for that compliment. It's very embarrassing. So please forgive me if I have said something inappropriate. Surely that means I spoke much beyond my realization, right? So I
Hari Bol, my question. Okay, Krishna says this verse twice in Bhagavad Gita. Manmana bhav mad bhakto mad yajimam namaskuru mami vaishi satyam te priyavasime in 9th as well as in 18th chapter. Mm. So this verse is like, we can say, materialism. How can we dovetail to spiritualism? Like, always think of me, always remember me, always to. So this verse says to us, like, because all these lectures what you said today, Pingala story, what all these stories you told. So this verse is apt for that.
Okay. Well, Manmanabha Bhakto Madhyaji Mam Namaskuru, Prabhupada says that one can remember Krishna through his vibhutis in the material world. I am the taste of water, I am the strength of the strong, and so on. So one can remember Krishna through vibhutis by seeing his presence in the material world. That way is one way, but more direct way is directly to hear and chant about. So this verse actually is recommending directly becoming his devotee by hearing about him, by chanting about him. Right? But the other way also is, right? Prabhupada says that. It is also a valid approach. But direct approach is always, one should directly as much as possible try to do directly also. Fine, so I will just like to end here by, I've been asked to also briefly just speak about Jahanu Saptami. Today is the day of Jahanu Saptami, which is the Jahanu Muni. As we know that when Mother Ganga descended on this earth, she was flowing and she flooded, and Bhagirath was going in front on his chariot, the Mother Ganga was flowing behind, and suddenly she swept away the ashrama of Jahanu Rishi. And Jahanu Rishi drank the entire Mother Ganga, right? And there's nothing now. Right? And thus, Bhagirath, again, he had to please Jahanu Rishi, who released the Ganga from his ears. Right? And thus, she became known as Jahanavi. So, this is the day, and Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami says, in one of the words, he compares the pastime of the Lord to be like Swar Dhuni, to be like Ganga, the flowing of the Ganga. Krishnaut kirtan gana nartana kala atho jani bhrajita shad bhaktavali hamsa chakra madhupa shreni viharaspadam karnanandi kaladhunir vahatume jivamaru prangane Shri Chaitanya Dayanidhe Tavalasal Leela Sudha Swardhuni. So Shri Chaitanya Dayanidhe Tavalasal Leela Sudha Swardhuni. So the Lord's pastime are compared to the nectarian Ganges water. And Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami says, let that Ganges flow on the surface of my desert like tongue. Jiva Maru, like a desert like tongue. Beautifying those waters are the lotus flowers of singing, dancing, and that of kirtan. Right? Kirtan, gaan, nartan, various artistic way of glorifying Krishna are like the lotus flowers which beautify. And also sporting within that waters are like the devotees who are compared to the hamsas and swans. So again, I'll just read some very beautiful purport of Prabhupada to end the class with. Prabhupada says, one's tongue always engage in vibrating useless sounds that do not help us realize transcendental peace. The tongue is compared to a desert because a desert needs a constant supply of refreshing water to make it fertile and fruitful. Water is the substance most needed in the desert. The transient pleasure derived from mundane topics of art, culture, politics, sociology, dry philosophy, poetry, and so on is compared to mere drop of water. Therefore, neither collectively nor individually can they satisfy the vast requirements of the desert-like tongue. Despite crying in various conferences, therefore, the desert-like tongue continues to be parched. For this reason, people from all over the world must call for the devotees of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who are compared to swans swimming around the beautiful lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, or bees humming around his lotus feet in transcendental pleasure, searching for honey. The dryness of material happiness cannot be moistened by so-called philosophers who cry for Brahman, liberation, and similar dry speculative objects. The urge of the soul proper is different. The soul can be solaced only by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his many bona fide devotees. Lord Chaitanya's movement of Krishna consciousness is full of dancing, singing about the pastime of the Lord. It is compared herein to the pure water of the Ganges, which are full of lotus flowers. The enjoyers of these lotus flowers are the pure devotees, who are like bees and swans. They chant like the flowing of Ganges, right? Kaladhuni, the river of the celestial kingdom. The author desires such sweetly flowing waves to cover his tongue. And Prabhupada says again something very beautifully. If the devotees can induce the dry tongues of materialistic people to chant the holy name of the Lord, as exemplified by Lord Himself, they would taste sweet nectar and enjoy life. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna, I just seek forgiveness for speaking beyond my realization. Hare Krishna.